Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly readings for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. I do want to make a quick update. If you guys are interested in private consultations, definitely look at the description box below. If you're interested in anything to do with candle magic, spell work, you guys will find my email on the link, on the description, sorry, and you'll be able to contact me through there. Also, I want to give a big shout out to one of my amazing clients. She's a private client of mine. Just an amazing woman, very encouraging, a very wise woman, Diane Marasco. Thank you very much, sweetheart. She sent me this coffee mug for Hallows Eve, and I was surprised she didn't tell me. She just sent it. As always, sweetheart, thank you very much. It says bruja, which in English means witch. I am just in love with it. So thank you, sweetheart. Thank you for sending that and thinking of me, yours truly. I do encourage you guys to check her out on Amazon. Check out her books, Diane Marasco. Again, like I said, she's an amazing author. So let's get into this reading, Scorpios. Let's see what spirit has for you guys. I was shuffling the cards before before I started recording, and for some reason the cards already started popping out. I do want to apologize. For some reason my TV just went on. Let me run real quick and turn it off. This usually happens when spirit guides are around, so electricity kind of goes bonkers. Anyways, give me one quick moment. Okay, so I'm back. Sorry about that. Again, like I said, that usually happens when spirit guides are around. Electricity kind of goes crazy. So anyways, let's get into your reading, Scorpios. Let's see what spirit has for you guys for the month of November 2017. Spirit, what are the messages for Scorpios for the month of November 2017? What are the messages for Scorpios for the month of November 2017? Okay, this is the last one more. Okay, so like I said, the first card popped out already. That was before I started recording that I was shuffling, and it is the Page of Cups, the Seven of Pentacles, the Five of Swords, the King of Cups, the Knight of Swords, the Eight of Pentacles, the Ten of Wands, the Nine of Cups, the High Priestess, wow, the Wheel of the Year, the Hermit, the Seven of Wands, the Nine of Wands, the Strength card, and the Ace of Cups. Wow. Okay, Scorpios, your general energies for the month of November 2017. You guys have, as a general energy, you have the Queen of Pentacles. The Queen of Pentacles is all about manifestations in the material sense, meaning if you guys have been struggling money-wise, finances have been short, you know, for some reason you keep bumping into expenses that are very unexpected, all of that's going to change for the month of November. You guys will start to experience that probably second week of November. As a general energy as well, you guys can be dealing with an earth sign. Earth sign would be a Capricorn, a Virgo, or a Taurus. This is a general energy, so these are the energies that you're bringing into the month of November. Again, a lot of manifestations, a lot of stability, a lot of growth, because the Queen of Pentacles is all that embodies success, triumph, materialization and manifestations of the material, meaning stability in regards to business and money. So anyways, let's get into this reading. Now, I do, based on the cards that I just pulled out, I do see that you guys have been struggling. You guys have been extremely having difficulty, blockages, a lot of stress in regards to the family dynamics. So it could be your children, it could be your household, But there's major changes as well. So let's get into the reading. You have here the Page of Cups. So there's a message coming through for you guys in regards to the past, as the Seven of Pentacles is next to it. But this is not in a negative sense. This is positive, because perhaps you guys are still dealing with a person from your past. It could be, you know, someone in regards to, like, if you have children by someone else and you're currently in a different relationship, it could be dealing with the father or the mother figure communication. But I do have the Five of Swords here, and it's right at the center of the reading. So the Five of Swords is having a lot of arguments or miscommunication, but it's ego-based, ego-driven. So what that means is there's not really much depth into the arguments. It's more about who's right and who's wrong, pointing the finger. So be very watchful and mindful about that, Scorpio. And if you are being the one that's put in that situation, where, you know, your partner may seem a little standoffish or cold, and almost like, you know, kind of fidgeting, fussing and fighting over the minimal things, just try the best you can to go through the waves, if you know what I mean. Again, like I said, it's the Five of Swords. So the Five of Swords could represent arguments, but no one is in the right, basically. So sometimes we have to pick our fights, so to speak. The Five of Swords could represent also an inner struggle within yourself, as it is right in the center of it. So it could be the fact that, for those of you guys that are currently single, it could be that you're dealing with two people at the present time. Could be a Leo, as the Strength card is here. Could be a Virgo, as the Hermit card is here. Or again, like I said, it could be an Earth sign, which would be a Capricorn, a Taurus, or a Virgo. Now, you know, on the contrast of that, perhaps you guys are dealing with a person, you're dealing with a new person, but this person that either you reach out or they reach out to you is a person from your past. Perhaps that there was petty arguments or things of that nature, that's the reason why you guys kind of went your own separate ways. Now, the King of Cups is here, and this is you, Scorpio. This is your energy, and you're looking towards the Knight of Swords. So I feel that a lot of you guys are guarded at the present time. For those of you guys that are single, you're not completely putting 100% into, if you are in fact dating, you're not putting 100% into, you know, the getting to know each other phase. Or it could be that you're guarded. You fear that they may judge you. You fear there's insecurities going on here. And again, it could also be a representation of the reason why you're double dealing or dealing with two different people could have to do, again, with the fear of committing yourself to something or putting more effort towards something, because you might feel like you might end up getting let down. So you do have the Eight of Pentacles here, and the Eight of Pentacles is that of business and finances, and it's next to the Ten of Wands. So there's a lot of expenses coming through, but I feel that for the this is the second week of November, and I feel for the second week, you're going to start to see a shift changing. You're going to start seeing more money coming in, not just money, but you're going to be able to experience being able to have more than enough and actually being able to put money away or save money. You do have the nine of cups here with the High Priestess, and these two cards could be a representation of at the present time. For those of you guys that are single, at the present time, you may feel like your primary focus has to do with work and finances, but your innate need or desire is that of companionship or something that is long-term, as the Nine of Cups does represent emotional fulfillment next to the High Priestess. The High Priestess is all-knowing, but it can also be all-knowing going within, being a little bit more introvert, really determining or really understanding your emotions and your needs. And I feel that at the present time, you may be ignoring it. You may be trying to, again, like I said, focus solely on business and finances. But nonetheless, I feel that for the second week of November, there's going to be progress in regards to getting clarity on the path you should be going towards or the person you should be going towards. Now, for those of you guys that are married or have been married for quite a while, again, like I said, if you guys have been experiencing a lot of expenses, and it's expenses that were not expected, you're going to start to see more abundance coming in, more stability, more growth, and more advancement. If there was, in fact, someone in your family or in your household that was having difficulties health-wise, etc., I do see progress here, as the Ten of Wands is a manifestation of stress, and it could have to do with, again, pentacles sometimes represent the body. So it could be stress that was coming from someone, a loved one, a child, even, you know, the person that you're with at the present time. Maybe they weren't doing so good. But finally, the Nine of Cups is here next to the High Priestess. So it's like you've been praying or you've been asking. Understand and know that the answers have been heard. The prayers have been heard, and you're going to be able to progress and move forward, knowing that there is abundance, there is health, there is strength coming in again. So just an FYI for you guys to know. Now, I feel that for the third week, you have here the Wheel of the Year and you have the Hermit, two major arcanas right next to each other. So there's a major transition happening here. Again, like I said, if there's been obstacles, all of that's going to slowly start to dissipate. You're going to start to see more advances, more opportunities coming your way, even extra income. So it could be income, something that you enjoy doing as, you know, a hobby or something, may turn into something professional, may turn into something that becomes that of a source of extra income on the side. But also the Wheel of Fortune could represent in regards to love, as you do have the Ace of Cups here. So there is a new beginning and a new progress for commitment and relationships for those of you guys that have been single for quite a while, as the Hermit can also represent a person that's been single for quite a while. And next to the Wheel of the Year, it's like your karmatic cycle is up and you're being able, kind of going on reset and moving forward. The key here is, as you do have the Knight of Swords, which is you being very guarded, being very protective of yourself, the High Priestess could be a person that you're interested in or that you're trying to connect with that may be very spiritual, very intuitive, or could be, you know, a teacher, quote unquote. It could be a person that's into the esoteric as well. But I feel that you're interested in them, but you're also guarded. And the Seven of Wands here being represented at the bottom is, it's definitely you being guarded and protecting yourself. But the thing next to the Hermit, what this is saying is, if you want to change your status, meaning if you want to be open to the possibility of unconditional love or something that's going to be long-term, you need to trust people. And I know this is really difficult for you Scorpios, because I know you guys have this innate natural instinct to mistrust people, because that is your sign. Scorpio is the sign of death. It represents everything that we must shed in order to continue evolving and growing. So that feeling of you know, I can't give myself 100% because I might get hurt is a natural instinct for you. It's a natural defense mechanism. But again, it is necessary at the present time. As the Strength card is next to it, what this is telling you is that if you are being guarded, you have to trust in yourself and you have to trust in the universe. You have to bring those wall downs and allow people to get closer to you. You know, Scorpios are extremely deep. You guys feel everything very deeply and in a different type of level of depthness compared to other signs. But again, the Strength card here is being represented as, you have to have the strength or the courage to give yourself another chance or to give yourself an opportunity of finding love. Also, be very careful if you guys are in fact dealing with a Leo, or if you're dealing with a fire sign. The fire sign would be an Aries, a Sagittarius, or a Leo. Like I said, be careful that that you're not being guided or you're not being persuaded in the physical form, purely on the physical form. So what I mean by that is, if there is this sexual tension between you guys and it's very, very prominent, know and understand that because you are the sign of death, there has to be some type of things that go deeper than just the superficial. Because if you are lured or being persuaded with a person because they're very good at using their sexuality or using their charisma to attract you, know and understand that that is just that is like, there is nothing that, if you, okay, so I'm getting a lot of messages, give me one second. Okay, know and understand that there must be depth into a person in order for you to see something long term. So if what you guys are looking for is one night stands, having fun, anything that has to do with passion, then by all means, if you are dealing with this Leo or this fire sign, then by all means continue to do so. But if what you're looking for is something long term, be very careful that you don't necessarily fall for the type that the sexual connection is there, but then there's nothing other than that that brings you guys together. Because I feel that this is something that has been repeated in your life. And the reason I say that is because you do have the Ten of Wands here, but you also have the Five of Swords and the Knight of Swords here, the Five of Swords and the Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles always speaks about the past, but it can also speak about errors or mistakes we've done in the past in regards to relationships. So be very mindful about that, Scorpios. Now, again, like I said, moving forward, there's going to be an opportunity to try to connect. So there might be, again, like I said, an earth sign, or there might be a Virgo particularly that's coming in for you guys, trying to connect with you guys on a deeper level. And here's the thing, the Nine of Wands is a representation of you being tired, being exhausted, being like you're not wanting to put effort. For those of you guys that are currently in a relationship, have been in a long-term relationship, and for some reason you guys have been dealing with a lot of, again, like I said, blockages, a lot of miscommunication, all of that is going to dissipate, but you need to put forth the effort to open up to your partner, speak to them about your fears, speak to them about what it is at the present time that is not helping you. It could be a characteristic like they're, you know, they could be extremely liberal. And for you Scorpios, you guys tend to be almost possessive, not in a negative unless you are in the shadow side, but not possessive in a bad way, but more so protective. And if they're very liberal, very free, that could freak you out. So again, don't suppress that, because what's going to happen is it's like slowly boiling until it gets to a point where it explodes. So it's now the time to open up and be courageous about it moving forward. I do see blessings for you guys. Again, like I mentioned, in regards to finances continue to grow or stabilize for you guys. Emotional fulfillment is right around the corner for you guys, for those of you guys that are single or have been single for a while. Also, those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship and you've been, again, like I said, having a lot of miscommunication, finally the doors are going to open for communication, where you guys are going to be able to connect and understand each other mutually, that it's going to bring you guys, with the wheel here, give you guys a lift. It's a changing karmatic cycle, and things are progressing in a positive way, and what you're going towards or where you're moving towards is new beginnings, as the Ace of Cups is here. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Comment, like, and share. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe. Also, I do want to mention, for the coming months, I'm going to be uploading the videos with those videos that are that have the most views or have the most comments are going to be the first videos going up. So definitely give some love and support to your sign, my dear Scorpio. So I'll see you guys soon in the middle of the month for the love readings. Okay, bye.